Integration of functions from C to C is defined in terms of functions from R to C. So we will need to learn how to deal with those integrations first. In this video, we'll see how they are defined, and we'll also learn how to differentiate those functions, which is fortunately quite similar to differentiation of real functions. So we look at functions from R to C, W from R to C, W as a function of T, split it in real and imaginary parts as U, T plus R times V of T, where T is just in R. So how is the derivative defined? dw dt equals w prime. You have to differentiate real and imaginary parts separately and then add them up as u prime plus r times v prime, as you would expect. So what happens if you compute, for example, the derivative of w squared? So what do you need to do? You have to write w squared in terms of u and v, split real and imaginary part and differentiate them separately. So we have the ddt of u plus I times v squared. Work out the brackets as u squared minus v squared plus 2 times I times u times v. Split real and imaginary part and differentiate those separately. So the ddt of u squared minus v squared plus I times the ddt of 2 times u times v. And for those of them, you can use results from the real calculus. Ddt of u squared minus v squared equals the 2 times u times u prime. Differentiate minus v squared, we get 2 times v prime, with additional minus sign. And for the ddt of 2 times u times v, we use the product rule, we get a 2 times u prime times v plus a 2 times u times v prime, that's the I, so there we are. And it looks rather strange. You would expect that, well, you have w squared, you differentiate, you would expect that you would get like 2 times w prime. Well, let's see, because maybe we have gotten that. Because if we compute 2 times w prime, so we get u plus I times v times u prime plus I times v prime, we get a 2u u prime plus 2u I v prime plus 2u prime I v minus 2v v prime. And then if we compare to the derivative of w squared, we see that we have 2u u prime is the same, 2i u v prime is the same, 2i v u prime is the same, and minus 2 v v prime is also the same. So you see the ddt of w squared is just 2 times w prime, as you would expect. Next example. Compute the derivative of e to the power z0 t, where z0 is now in c. So you expect to get z0 times e to the power z0 t, but you don't know, because we have those, well, rather strange complex functions. Well, let's try. What do we get? First we compute e to the power z0 t equals e to the power x naught t plus I times y naught t equals e to the power x naught t, and e to the power I y naught t yields cosine y naught t plus I times sine y naught t. But what happens if we differentiate this? We have to differentiate the real part, so we have to differentiate e to the power x naught t times cosine y naught t. That yields e to the power x naught t times cosine y naught t over here. And it yields also e to the power x naught t times the derivative of the cosine of the y naught yields minus y naught sine y naught t over there. And we differentiate the imaginary part, so we get x naught times e to the power x naught t times I sine y naught t. That's over the term over here. And we get e to the power x naught t times the derivative of the sine of y naught t, so I y naught cosine y naught t. So there we are. And now we can simplify this a bit. We have e to the power x naught t over here times x naught cosine y naught. So put that one over here. We have an e to the power x naught t is the cosine y naught t and I times y naught over there. And we have again x to the power x naught t and x naught plus I times sine y naught. So that's this one. And finally we have e to the power x naught t, this term, minus y naught times sine y naught t minus y naught equals I squared times y naught. So that equals I times y naught times I. And if you rearrange the terms like this, you observe, hey, we have a z naught over here, the z naught over there. We can take the z naught out as well. And what you're left with cosine y naught plus I times sine y naught. So what you see is that you have just z naught times e to the power z naught t. So in this case, you have the same result as you would have for a real case. There are some differences, though, as we'll see in the third example. In the mean value theorem for calculus, we have that you have some point C in between A and B, where the derivative equals WB minus WA divided by B minus A. Basically says if you have some continuous function, you are always have some point in between A and B where you will go travel at the average speed. This one does not hold anymore in a complex case. For example, if you take W to be the exponential function, A to be 0 and B to be 2 pi, then WA equals WB equals 1, they are the same. E to the power 2i minus e to the power 0, 1 minus 1 equals 0. So your B minus WA over B minus A equals 0. However, the derivative of W prime is everywhere equal to 1, so it's never equal to 0. So the fact that you can find somewhere in WC equal to WB minus WA over B minus A, no one is not true anymore. So differentiation of those functions from R to C is very similar to the real counterparts, but as always, you have to be careful.